All right, hello everyone. This is going to be a review of ICT setups for Friday, June 2nd, 2023. Quick disclaimer, I am not a registered financial advisor, and the following is not a solicitation in the purchase, sale, transfer, or any other disposition of the securities or derivatives product. Trade at your own risk. Okay, so what we're going to do here is just quickly go through some of the setups that that appeared on Friday, June, what is it, Friday, June the 2nd. First off, I want to say that I wouldn't have found all of these, and I'm not trying to brag. I don't want any sort of praise or anything like that. It's just an objective analysis. So, these are our ICT key setup times. So, what do we see here? So, remember that algorithmic theory is based off of it's based off of time and then price. So, we're looking basically to put pending orders in the market somewhere around these times. So, this is all in New York local time. So for me, I'm in Central Time. It would be an hour earlier than this. At 0200, we have the Frankfurt Stock Exchange open. 0300, we have the London Stock Exchange open. At 0830, we have a news embargo that lifts. 0930, we have the New York Stock Exchange open. Between 12 and 1300, we have the New York lunch. And then between 1515 and 1545, we have the market on close macro. So we're only looking at taking trades at that time. During those times or in and around those times. So we're not worrying about Asian range. It's a very illiquid market. ICT says not to trade Asia, so we're not trading Asia. And what we're trying to do is we're always going to try and enter in on a pending or a limit order. We're not trying to market smash in. So with that being said, let's go back to our chart and let's mark out the for Friday. So this is going to be, we're just going to do this on a 5 minute chart. And I want Friday. So ICT teaches that the new day starts at midnight. So that's when our time starts. We're trying to look for confluence, so we use multiple of ICT's models, optimal trade entry, model 2022, fair value gaps, volume imbalances. We're really looking to try and get multiple models that are suggesting the same thing. So I usually like to start with optimal trade entry. And what we're going to do is we're going to mark out. So there's our Frankfurt open. And rather than use the replay button, I'm just going to basically pretend like you didn't see the action before. So going into the Frankfurt Open, we didn't really have a good setup here. The only thing that, maybe you could have seen is, let's take a look here. We didn't really get an optimal trade entry on the Frankfurt Open. The only thing that we maybe could have seen would be this little volume imbalance and try and enter in on a limit buy there. Other than that, nothing really on the Frankfurt Open. Now let's take a look at London Open. So London Open is where it gets a little bit more interesting. So that blue line there is London Open, and we have to imagine that we didn't have that open yet. So first thing we want to look for is to see if we have an optimal trade entry. So we have a break in structure kind of here, a sweep of the high. So we could potentially look at our optimal trade entry from here. That doesn't really give us anything. If we decide to ignore using the opens and closes and use the wicks, let's see. We have a swing low. We have a swing high. Optimal trade entry is not really going to get us a good entry here. if we take it from the Frankfurt Open low and we take it right before London opens, it would have been difficult to see this. Doesn't quite reach it, so no optimal trade entry on London Open. We do have on London Open, though, this fair value gap that we could have bought on. So we could have this. So that was one setup that we had. Other than that, let's see, during the London session, which would be 3 to 5, during this block of time, we don't really have on the 5-minute chart any other good setups. If we call this a break of structure, yeah, it never really comes back down to an optimal trade entry during the London session. So we had one setup on the London Open, and it would have come in 15 minutes after London Open. And if we got long on this fair value gap, we're looking at, in the London session, a 7.5-point move, and then maybe up to 13 points if you held it longer. Okay, let's go to the 8:30 news embargo. This was non-farm payrolls. And let's first see if there was an optimal trade entry. So we're looking for prior to the big 8:30 candle. You have to imagine that that non-farm payroll candle didn't exist yet. Let's see. So we have a second break of structure here. Let's get an important swing low. You know, either way you pull it, if you pull it from the body to body, we'll say this body here. So on non-farm payrolls, obviously you would have needed to have been on a pending buy. But let's see if our optimal trade entry lines up with any fair value gaps. No fair value gaps. But we do see confluence with some volume imbalances here. So you could have gotten long on an optimal trade entry. If you pull the fib from the wicks, it'd be a little bit of a worse entry. If you pull it from the bodies of the candle, and this is just from that London open swing low, which to me would be a significant low that price moved away from, and then up to the highest swing high prior to that 8:30 news release. So okay, so that is that. And then let's take a look at 09:30. So if we imagine that the action at 09:30, if this candle did not exist, so on the blue line, we're imagining that that blue line does not exist. Let's see if there was anything on the open. No. Not really. Let's see. If this candle didn't exist, we're going to be aware there is a OB plus FVG here. So, if we had pending buys here, there's a couple different So we always want to be trying to enter in on a limit order, and sometimes we're going to aim for basically right when that key time happens, so our 9:30 equity's open. But sometimes you're not going to get your pending order filled right on the key time or right on the open, right? Sometimes you're going to have to wait some period of time. So I think we said after London Open, we waited 10, 15 minutes to get filled. And here in the New York Equities Open, if we were waiting to get filled on a buy, we had a lot of confluence here. So if we use our non-farm payroll swing, or let's pull it, and we're just using the opens instead of the wicks. I mean, either way, let's see if we actually would have been filled on the wicks. Yeah, so, I mean, if whether you're using the wicks or the bodies, you're going to get filled on a pending long here. But I think how ICT would do it would be with this, the open of this candle and then the close of our 9:40 candle here. So we have an optimal trade entry. It's a fair value gap, and it's also it looks like an order block because we had a change in the state of delivery here. So it's a lot of confluence here, right? Optimal trade entry, fair value gap, and it's also an order block. So you had a lot of confluence that price would want to come back here to fill your pending buy. So there was your 9:30s equity open setup. And we're, by the way, this was also this was a model 2022. Why was it a model 2022? Because we had an impulse leg higher that broke structure. We retraced back down into a fair value gap, and then we moved higher. So it's there's a lot of similarity obviously between the model 2022 and the optimal trade entry. Both would have given you a pending buys there. So now we're gonna look at New York lunch. It's gonna be 12-1. And see if we had any sort of confluence. So I would say no. The only thing, let's see if optimal trade entry gave you anything. Well, that's not true. Let's see. Potentially, you had an OTE because we had a bullish price leg that broke a little bit of structure here. So, we're going to say so potentially you could have had an optimal trade entry here because we had a bullish leg that broke a little bit of structure here. I would have pulled this one from the wicks. And in any event, you have pending longs here. So maybe optimal trade entry would have gotten you there. There's no fair value gap formed here, so I think the only thing that really gets you there is going to be that optimal trade entry based on this last price swing. So going into lunch, we didn't make a new low, so that would be the only entry that I would potentially see here, would be pending buys on optimal trade entry at lunch. And then our final time setup is going to be our market on close. So 15:15 to 15:45. So we're trying to get in on a pending order if possible. And the only thing, let's see, so we'd want to be bullish, right? Because we had an impulse leg that moved higher. So let's see if we got an optimal trade entry. So you had a potential optimal trade entry in this candle that was also the mean threshold of this order block. And that would be the only thing on the market on close that I would be looking for. So we had an impulse leg higher that broke some structure, broke this order block here, it broke this structure here. So we broke a high here, and we broke another short-term high. And then if we're using the bodies of the candles instead of the wicks, we got to the 0.62. Let's see if we use the wicks. We didn't get filled if we use the wicks. I don't think, no. So, you know, this would have been tough. You would have had to been right on the 0.62 at that 4289.50. It comes right down and barely touches that. So I don't know if you would have been filled on this. You would have had to have front run it by a tick, or I think you would have been hit by the spread. But, you know, your last trade of the day could have been 4 points, 4.5 up to 4.75 points. And that's basically it. Those are all of our pending setups. We saw that lunch gave us a setup, London gave us a setup, 8:30 open on non-farm payrolls gave us a setup, and then 9:30 equities open gave us a setup. So the good thing about the optimal trade entry is you can use it basically with the model 2022, you can use it with the fair value gaps, you can use it with order blocks. So the optimal trade entry, which is kind of his first flagship pattern prior to the fair value gap becoming the new hotness, you can pull these optimal trade entries, you know, all the time, basically. Like, and you see confluence with a fair value gap and with an order block like that, you put your pending order right there, there's a good chance that's going to get hit. You could have even put it at the higher order block or right at the 0.62. So we see that the 0.62 optimal trade entry came right on this little order block right here, but you could have even been filled all the way down to the 0.79. So anyways, I would say that the optimal trade entry is a very flexible pattern because you're just looking for breaks in structure and retracements in that same direction. And so those are basically the times that you're looking for it. Again, your setup times for your day trading looks like this. And you want to memorize these. So 0200 to 0300, that's when the Frankfurt Stock Exchange opens. He calls that the London session opening, but that's really not what that is. That's the Frankfurt Stock Exchange opening. The London Stock Exchange opens an hour later than that, and it's going to open up in 0300. So 0300 is going to be our London Stock Exchange open. 0830 is going to be our news embargo lift. Our 0930 is going to be our New York Stock Exchange open. Our 1200 to 1300 is going to be our New York lunch, and our 1515 to 1545 is going to be our market on closed macro. Some other times worth noting again is going to be 2000, which is the Tokyo Stock Exchange open. The Tokyo AM session goes from 2000 to 2230. And the New York Midnight Open is at 4:00. It's at 0:00. 11:30 Eastern Standard, New York local time, the London Stock Exchange closes. And then from 10 to 11, that's when the London final hour of trade happens. We're also going to look for any resettlement periods. And then we always want to ask what day of the week it is. What week of the month is it? So if we're in Friday, right, Friday's going to be our fifth day of the week. It was the last day of May. May is the January, February, March, April, May is the fifth month of the year. It's in the second quarter of the year, and it's in the first half of the year. So going into our next trading session, which is going to be June 5th, it's going to be the first day of the week, the first week of the June trading month. It's going to be the sixth month of the year, the third quarter of the year, and the second half of the year. What does all that mean? Well, if we look on our higher time frames, like let's go up to our weekly, and we can see if we just peruse through. So let's start in December of 2022. So December was a bearish month, and then January was basically a bullish month. February was a bearish month. We did have a run in the last part of February. March was a mixed month because we had our first week of March was a big bearish candle. I think really that you would call that probably, I guess, the end of February, which is overall a bearish month. And then the last 3 weeks of March were three big bullish candles. And then going into April, looks like we consolidated. So we consolidated for the 4 weeks in April. And then coming into May, the first 2 weeks of May were consolidations, and then we expanded in the last the last 5 weeks of May. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, so not exactly accurate on the trading view, but let's just say that May was mostly a bullish month, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4. We had a bullish month of May. So if we're expecting this pattern of our bullish to bearish months, then coming into our first week of June, we might expect to pop up to fill this weekly volume imbalance at 4303 to get up to that 4300 big figure. It's kind of what I'm expecting to get, at least a run a little bit higher. And then if this monthly trading range pattern continues, we would expect that the last 3 weeks of June, that June would overall be a black candle, right? Because that's kind of been our pattern, is that every month reverses the prior month. So I'm kind of thinking that that's what we're potentially going to do, is we're going to have a pop on Monday to fill in the weekly volume imbalance, and then come back down for 3 weeks of bearishness in June. It would make sense. It's the third quarter of the year. It's the second half of the year, and it's a new month. So we might expect that there would be a shift in market sentiment with all those time factors. So that's something to think about. But in terms of your day trading, here are your key times. Keep those in mind. That's when you want to be doing your trading and looking for your setups, and you want to try and enter in on pending orders if possible. And you want to always try and use multiple of ICT's models. If you can find confluence between multiple models, especially with the optimal trade entry, those are going to be your like golden setups, basically. You find an optimal trade entry with a fair value gap that's also on an order block or a breaker block, you're looking at a really like A+ setup. So that's it. Bye-bye.